Oh, look, Bill, where do you start when you're talking about Dino? He was a properly larger-than-life character. Firstly, he was a hell of a player. Probably a better player than people actually realised at the time. He averaged 46 over 52 test matches, which speaks for itself. As you've just heard so many people talking about that introduction, he reinvented the way one-day cricket was played. He took it to a whole new level. He was also an incredibly good player for his beloved Victoria. He loved playing cricket for Victoria. We played, Fat, in three Shield matches in a row, if you like, 3 years of Shield matches in a row at the MCG. I reckon it was in the early 90s. The first year we came over, South Australia, Victoria at the MCG, he made 200s in the same game. That was the first year. The next year we came back, 200s the same game. Next year we came back, he made a double 100. And then the third year we came back, he made a triple century. 300 in the one innings. In fact.
So 100, 100, 200 and a 300.
And a 300. In three sort of years of playing Shield games at the MCG. And in fact, I remember he was in the middle of making 300. The only time I ever saw live anyone make a 300. Actually, that's not true. Jeff Marsh made one in Perth one day. But anyway, I'm out there walking from first slip to first slip. And seriously, mate, we didn't look like getting him out. And that came on the back of the previous year, 200. The previous year to that, 200s in the one game. So anyway, we'd had enough. We'd had enough of looking at him. So I'm walking from first slip to first slip. And he was on about 280. And I said to him, Dino, why don't you do us all a favour and off. He pissed. He used to have this stupid high-pitched laugh. He'd go, hey, you're not going to get me out in a week. You will never get me out on this. And, mate, we weren't going to either. I don't even reckon we did get him out. It was So he was an incredibly good player. He's still the best runner between the wickets I've ever seen. And, Bill, that's a very underrated part of the game of cricket, I reckon. He loved the challenge of it. He loved turning ones into twos and twos into threes. But
spot on.
The other thing he loved doing, he loved the ego of taking certain fielders on. So he'd be out there batting and he'd look at the fielder and go, so you think you got a good arm? Watch me beat it. Yep. That was how he sort of, his mind worked. And ego is an often heard word when describing Dino because he had a healthy one. But it had, and you know this, it had a charm with it. Once you knew... you know, it was part of the Dean Jones sort of package. He had this great charm. And I said to a really good mate of his who I knew would be devastated, so we sort of spoke earlier today, and I said to him, this guy played as well, I said, I legitimately couldn't stand Dino when we played against each other, mainly because we could never get him out. But he was an antagonist, Fat. He'd hold the bowler up at the top of his mark. He'd ask for a change of gloves at the most inappropriate time. He did stuff that he knew would antagonise the opposition. And he especially loved getting under the skin of the opposition leaders. So with us, it was Jamie Siddons and Darren Lehman. And they'd crack the shits with him. And then he'd start laughing that they'd get angry. And I remember we'd walk into the dressing rooms at lunchtime and tea time. And I'd say to them, boys, you're tipping into him again. He is doing it so that you'll get angry. And they got angry. But what I realised later on, we got to do a lot of work together on TV, pay TV doing commentary, was how wrong I had him, Fat. He was actually a beauty. He had a massive heart. He was incredibly generous. He had time for everyone. And he loved his girls. And by the way, they loved him. Janie, his beautiful wife, Isabella and Phoebes. They adored Dino. They will be understandably devastated. 59 is way too young. But I will say this when I finish talking about Dean Jones. He was always larger than this life. But don't worry, Fat. You know this. He'll push his shoulders back and he'll walk into the next life and he'll be very confident he can dominate that one too. That's just
exactly
what he's like.
Right. Spot on. Very confident, as you said. And he loved his... and you worked with him too, and you found out he was a good bloke.
Yep.
But I did a couple of sporties. We used to do our sporties with him over there in Perth with Mouse, of course. And mate, you get... And you never knew... Like, I grew up watching him, and you love watching him play cricket, but he'd bowl in. He was a big... He was a big presence, wasn't he?
He was. And he was, mate. Larger than life, as I say.
Yeah, he wouldn't put up with any crap, by the way, from anyone either. But he'd sit up there and he'd love to talk. He loved to talk about, you know, he's 210 at Madras and how hot it was. And he used to blow that up, put on some mayonnaise. Richard Hadley, how He only got me out three times. He was a, you know, nearly the best bowler I faced. And he wore the sunnies. He used to talk about that a bit in his sporties and things like that. But what he did talk about, Jim, about himself, did he talk about himself and Ad Mayo and all that? And he was he was good company. He was really, really, good company.
He's a beauty. He'd tell you how he was friends with the stars, how good a mate of his Greg Norman was, or Elton John was, or Paul Hogan was, or... You know, but they were. They all knew him. They all loved him. And as I say, it took, for me anyway, it took me to stop playing against him and start working with him to realise just what a special bloke he was. And, you know, he loved the game of cricket. That's the other thing. Some people tell you they love cricket, but he legitimately loved the game of cricket. He loved nothing more than sitting with a beer or a glass of wine and talking about the game of cricket. It wouldn't take him, as you said, wouldn't take him long to turn it back on himself. But he did. He just loved it. And he loved competing when he played, and then he loved being around cricket when he finished. And 59 is too young.
Antagonise, as you said. What about the one with Curtly Ambrose? When... Yeah. He's curtly storming in and he stops him, asks him to take off his sweatband. And he was talking about it last night. They had it on Fox Cricket, actually. And Mark Taylor's down the other end going, mate, I've got two kids at home.
Yeah.
I'm going to get killed out of here on the ground. Like, mate, and he just got, and Curtly was, he was upset. He just couldn't wait. But as Dino said, guess what? He didn't get me out.
No, he didn't. But he had great courage, and that came through whenever you watched him play. It didn't matter how fast the bowling was, or that famous test in Madras when it was stinking hot and he made 200. He just had this incredible courage and will to compete.
Yeah, valued his wicket. He said his best innings was, believe it or not, his first game, first test, when he played against the West Indies over there and made 48.
Yeah, that was back in the day of, you know, I think it was Joel Garner and Malcolm Marshall and all of those boys. And, yeah, that would have been frightening. I think AB made 190 in the other innings of that game. But, there's no doubt he had extraordinary courage. And, as I say, he revolutionised one-day cricket. And he made that double 100 against the West Indies at the Adelaide Oval when he shared that big partnership with Merv, and Sir Donald Bradman came in after the game. And Patrick Patterson looked at him and said... How did you make all those runs? You're only about this high. And he put his hand out. He said, I'd have no trouble getting you out. This is Patrick Patterson to Sir Donald Bradman. And Bradman turned around, pointed to Merv and said, get me out. You couldn't even get him out.
But Sir Donald.
He was a beauty, mate. And he'll be greatly missed. He's a legend of the Australian Cricket Hall of Fame and richly deserved that. But as I say, my thoughts and our thoughts, Fat, go out to... his beautiful girls, who will be absolutely devastated at the loss of their beautiful dad and husband. And so to Janie, Isabella and Phoebs, we send you every bit of love we've got.